connection with Madison Square Garden, take great pleasure in presenting the World Boxing Council World Lightweight Championship fight scheduled for 12 rounds between the challenger Edwin El Chapo Rosario and the WBC champion Hector Macho Camacho. This WBC championship fight is sanctioned by the World Boxing Council, Jose Suleiman, president, and is approved by the New York State Athletic Commission. The former light heavyweight champion of the world and the chairman, Jose Chegui Torres, and the commissioners, Rose Stretman and Jimmy Dupree. The deputy commissioners, Petey Della, Jack Graham, Marvin Kahn. The WBC judges, Louis Rivera from New York City, Tony Castellano from New York City, and from Detroit, Michigan, Dr. Stuart Kirschenbaum. The timekeeper is Cecilio Pedraja. Counting for the knockdowns at the bell, referee Johnny Lobianco. The doctors in attendance at ringside, Dr. Frank S. Folk, chief medical physician, Dr. Billy Layton, and Dr. Barry Jordan. The referee in the ring at this time, Arthur Mercanti. This contest, 12 rounds for the WBC Lightweight Championship of the World. In this corner, he's wearing black trunks trimmed with white. He weighed in at 134 pounds. His home is Santurce, Puerto Rico. He is a former WBC lightweight champion. He is a number one contender. His career record, he won 23 bouts. He lost only one and registered 19 exciting KOs. Here is a very capable challenger, Edwin El Chapo Rosario. He's wearing red, white, and blue trunks. He weighed in at 135 pounds. He's from New York City. He was the 78, 79, 80 Golden Glove champion. He won the North American Boxing Federation championship. He was the WBC Junior Lightweight champion. He's a current World Boxing Council lightweight champion. He's undefeated in 28 professional fights, exploding 15 stunning knockouts along the way. Here is the very worthy champion, Hector Macho Camacho. 12 rounds. Referee Arthur McCarthy will deliver the instruction to the boxer.
McCarthy calls the two combatants to the zone. Camacho in his flashy trunks with a Puerto Rican flag, red, white, and blue. El Chapo, Edwin Rosario in the black trunks with a Puerto Rican flag on his right leg. The question now, the punching power of Camacho. They mix it up early. The heads come together. Very quick on his feet is Hector Camacho. Camacho has lightning foot speed to go with lightning hand speed. He's not the biggest banger in the world, but he has 16 knockouts and 29 wins. Tries to work downstairs to Edwin Rosario. Rosario extremely intelligent in the ring. You get the idea because Rosario's been around so long, fighting since he was about 16 years old, that he's much older than age 23. But in fact, Camacho is a year older at 24. Again, the 10-point must-scoring system. Scoring done by three judges. The referee has no say. Camacho goes wild with the left hand. Tries to score with a big hook. Very interesting to point out that Jimmy Montoya, who's worked all through the career of Hector Camacho, just today, Johnny Mag was telling me from the Don King camp that he switched camps and moved over to Edwin Rosario. Whether that'll have any factor or any psychological bearing on the fight, I do not know. But to this point, Camacho is a strong favorite to win this fight, retain his championship. But Rosario is so slick. Talking to Mickey Duff earlier, the fellow who handles the likes of Cornelius Boza Edwards and most of the great fighters out of England, including Frank Bruno, who will fight Tim Witherspoon next month. He thinks Rosario's got a good shot in this fight. So far, it's Camacho forcing the fight. He's backing off. Rosario plodding forward. But Camacho's the type of fighter that uses his foot speed in conjunction with a great hand speed. About 45 seconds to go in round number one. Again, the schedule for 12. Rosario gets through. A very, very even first round. Rosario coming forward. Camacho taking the steps back, bouncing from side to side. But it's Camacho that controls the pace of the fight, because when there is to be a mix-up, it's Camacho that forces it. He gets through. Gets through with the left and works the right to the body. And Rosario ties him up. This is going to be a good boxing show, believe me. Both fellas, excellent, excellent boxing skills. There's the bell, ending round, championship of the world. Hector Camacho putting his title on the line again. Right hand almost clicking that time, thrown by Rosario. I know you people watching in Puerto Rico, when they mix it up like that, they've got to be going crazy down there. Glad that you can be with us on the Don King Sports and Entertainment Network. Rosario is not intimidated by Macho Camacho. He wants to control the pace of the fight. He keeps coming in towards Camacho, but Camacho is so quick on his feet. He's so elusive when Rosario throws his shots. And up until the time we saw Camacho in the lightweight division, we thought Rosario had pretty good hand speed. Rosario holding those gloves very high around the face, up there so Camacho can't get through. But Camacho, to me, looks like he's much more powerful than is Rosario. There was the question pre-fight about hanging on, holding and hitting. The camp of Rosario complaining about Camacho. We haven't seen any of that under the tutelage of referee Arthur Mercanti, one of the best in the business. Now, while Rosario continues to plod forward, it's Camacho that's getting the points, because he's actually landing the leather. Even though he's backing off, when he decides to come in, he's landing more punches than is Rosario. Kind of a frustrating sort of fight for Rosario with that respect. Very difficult target to hit is Camacho. Good right hand gets through, thrown by Rosario that time. Rosario tries to back him into the corner. Nothing works there. We're in the second round with about 40 seconds to go. This is scheduled for 12, the WBC limit. And again, as you watch, it's Camacho just coming in, delivering a blow or two, and getting out again. Really on the bicycle the whole time, up on his toes, bouncing around. And there you see the hand speed of Camacho. Rosario almost had it measured, and you heard Arthur Mercanti say, hey, stop holding. Keeping control of this fight. The WBC Lightweight Championship on the line. Hector Camacho in the red, white, and blue trunks to the left of your screen. Edwin Rosario now to the left of your screen. Chapo written across the tubing on his trunks, wearing the black trunks. It's been an even fight so far. Really, there haven't been too many times where they've really mixed it up like that. Once in the second round. That time a pretty good mix up there, pretty good exchange. It's Camacho bouncing around and picking shots. Rosario, as he plods forward, looking for the opportunity to land the big shot. fighters landed good punches in that exchange. Rosario landed a right hand. Camacho landed a left hook. Neither fighter visibly shaken by being tagged by the other man. Camacho, we've never seen in trouble. Rosario will go down. Right hand lands, but light. Right hand gets through, takes no effect on Camacho. All it does is ignite him a little bit more. Get the adrenaline pumping a bit more. Right hand gets through. This is the best round thus far for Edwin Rosario. Again, the lightning right hand bops Rosario right on the nose. As he pulls in, continues to come in. Well, it's Camacho that's controlling the pace of it. Rosario walks in on a left hand that time. Southpaw style of Camacho hasn't confused Rosario too much. I think Camacho in this round is beginning to realize he's in against a real tough opponent. Again, this has been the best round for Edwin Rosario. Inside of 15 seconds remaining in the round now. Coming to you live from Madison Square Garden in New York City. The one-time boxing mecca of the world, and these two great lightweights at it. The former champ, Edwin Rosario. The reigning champ, Hector Macho Camacho, has his title on the line and his hands full with Edwin Rosario. I've got the fight scored dead even right now. The first round, too even to call. The second round, slightly in favor of Camacho. The third round, in Rosario's favor. We're in round number four. If you're a student of the game of boxing, watching these two guys is some show.
Stop. 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 You stop holding. Hit it.
All right, again, Arthur Mercanti warns Camacho about holding and hitting. It was a big issue before the fight, and he's controlled it. To be honest, I didn't even see him hold and hit that time. I saw him hang on, but so did Rosario. But Mercanti staying right on top of the champion, Hector Camacho. And rightfully so, it's illegal. Camacho again, if you don't know by now, in the red, white, and blue trunks. Rosario in the black trunks. And we've got a good one here. Out at 35 at the limit is Camacho. Rosario in at 134, just a pound lighter. Everything else in the statistics about even. Their age only a year apart. The height is exactly 5'6", both of them, and they each have a 67-inch reach. Nobody really taking a command in this, the fourth round. Good crowd reaction every time Rosario lands a shot on Camacho. Yet when Camacho came into the ring, the crowd went crazy. He's so flamboyant, so colorful. Been a long time since lightweights have stirred up this kind of enthusiasm. Nice right hand nails Camacho. Now Mercanti talks to Camacho about hitting low. And maybe some of these tactics are bothering Camacho. He can't do anything. The Mercanti isn't right on top of him. And I think Rosario's controlling the round now. Excellent. excellent job by referee Arthur McCarthy. It looks like Camacho's cut on the right eye, and if he is cut, it looks like a good one. Bob Sheridan on the Don King Sports and Entertainment Network. We've got the WBC lightweight champion in there against Edwin Rosario, the former champ. And he is ignited. He was cut in the fourth round and maybe posted in round three and four. All of a sudden, Camacho wants to mix it up bad. He's holding and hitting, and McCarthy will be right on top of him for it.
Stop holding!
The blood in the corner of the left eye. It's in a bad spot. If he's nailed there again. He's nailed by Rosario. He's got him in trouble. The champ's in trouble. It's the first time I've ever seen him hurt. He's in big trouble. He's nailed again by Rosario. Rosario rattling away at the champion. The champ tries to hang on. He's out on his feet. Hector Camacho's legs are starting to go. He's nailed again by Rosario. Rosario nails him with a left hook. Tries to get him with a right hand. Good right hand again. Camacho is definite trouble here. Good shots being landed by the challenger. Another right hand lands right on top of that cut. Camacho bleeding from the nose. Nailed with the right hand again. Bleeding around the eye. On the bridge of the nose. He's nailed by the right hand again. Camacho hit with the left. Another left hook catches him. This could be a big upset in the making if it continues like this. Camacho almost bewildered by Rosario. Camacho's as tough as they come. He wouldn't go down, and his legs were wobbled. Rosario working to the head, working to the body. Camacho's face is a mess out there right now. Another good right hand bounces him on the nose. I wouldn't be surprised if he's got a broken nose right now. He's bleeding from the nose, bleeding from the eyes. He's got a cut across the bridge of his nose. It looks to me that his nose has been flattened out. Good right hand. Another vicious right hand. Camacho is so tough, he won't go. He can't take many more shots like that, though. Rosario having it all his way right now. The right hand catches Camacho again. Works to the body. Camacho is so businesslike out there. Camacho trying to make a go of it. Inside of 14 seconds to go on the round. Inside of 10 seconds now. He'll survive the fifth round anyway. A big, big round for Edwin Rosario. The bell is in time. He almost went down. It was a vicious left hook. And he was wide open for it. You see Rosario trying to go downstairs. And Camacho fighting to hang on. The cut doesn't appear to be too bad next to the left eye. Coming up to round six. Is it an upset in the making, or will a macho man prove too much for Rosario? That's what this is all about. And at stake, the WBC Lightweight Championship of the World. The champ has got his hands full right now with Rosario. He's got the bounce back in his legs. There's one thing for sure. Camacho didn't panic. We've never seen him hit and hurt before. He was definitely hurt in that fifth round. He didn't go down, but his legs buckled. And Rosario stayed very, very businesslike throughout. Didn't go crazy trying to knock him out. Stayed under control. Rosario, great former champion. And this fight is all we thought it would be and more. Again, we're in round six. A minute gone in round six now. Kind of a coasting round for both fighters. Rosario doing the same thing he's been doing throughout, and that's stalking, continually stalking, backing up Camacho. Camacho was cut in the fourth round. He almost went down in the fifth. It looked to me at one stage a straight right hand of Edwin Rosario may have broken the nose of Camacho in the fifth round. In the sixth round, we haven't had the action that we had in the previous couple of rounds, but you can't expect that every round. Camacho goes downstairs again. McCanthy has warned him about hitting low, about hanging on and hitting. And just about at the time, I was wondering if that was frustrating Camacho. Rosario all of a sudden nailed him with a left hook that almost put him to the canvas. Again, Rosario takes some body shots that time. Now, once again, McCanthy warns him about hitting below the belt, and the crowd in attendance doesn't like it. But McCanthy is an excellent referee, and he's not going to tolerate anything.
What's that low blow?
Again, he warns him, and that time it was clear to me that he did hit him with a low blow. And all of his shots to the body are right at the belt or slightly below. I don't think it's an intentional thing, but whether it's intentional or not, just like in the Jerry Cooney, Larry Holmes fight, a low blow is a foul. And a guy can be penalized for it. And right now, Hector Camacho can't afford to lose any rounds and lose any points because of low blows. He's trailing in the fight. That's unofficial. But I'm sure he's trailing on most of the judges' scorecards.
Okay, let's go.
All right, this is round number 7. And a most interesting fight. A fight where Camacho appeared in the second round and started taking command of the fight. Then Rosario, I thought, won a close third round. And to me, Rosario's won 3, 4, 5, and 6. He definitely won 5 by a couple of points. He almost had the champion off his feet. Split him open in the fourth round. So a real good fight for Edwin Chapo Rosario. I have Rosario unofficially 59-56, 3 points out in front in the fight. Again, my scoring is only an indication. The judges do the official scoring. Good shot that time by the Macho Man. Nice job by the corner of Hector Camacho. He was cut in the fourth round, and the cut in the corner of his eye really hasn't been a factor thus far. It was a distraction to him, and all of a sudden, the Macho Man comes back. It seems as though the people at ringside attendance close by the ring are very much in favor of Camacho. The people sitting back in the galleries seem to be in favor of Edwin Rosario. So we got a mixed crowd. Everybody in attendance is enjoying it, including me. Here's the Macho Man trying to fight back and climb right back into this fight. Not that he's that far out of it. Again, the Macho Man holds.
Let's go.
Very tough fight for both fighters. We saw again quickly Camacho grab with the right hand and nail him with the left. He's so quick with his hands, sometimes you miss it. And that's why the people are screaming when McCanthy warns him about holding on and hitting. He's so slick and so cute at it, sometimes you don't even pick it up. Southpaw style hasn't confused Rosario at all. He's fighting with the shoulders very squared. Nice right hand gets through, spins the head of the champ. Camacho will hang on and use his forearm to set the guy's head up. He'll do all kinds of things. Very rough guy to fight. Inside of 10 seconds, you see the countdown in the corner of the screen. Rosario lost his balance at 10. The barrier. All right, this is round number 8. And an action-packed, very busy, scheduled 12-round WBC Lightweight Championship fight. I'm Bob Sheridan on the Don King Sports and Entertainment Network, and you're watching Hector Macho Camacho in action against Edwin Rosario. Rosario has given Camacho all he can handle in this fight.
Up holding,
McKinney has warned Camacho about low blows no less than four or five times, and holding probably a half a dozen more. Thus far, he hasn't taken a point away. He's being most fair with Macho Camacho. Right hand gets through by Rosario. Works the body of Camacho. You hear referee Edwin McKinney warning them about watching their heads. In a fight like this, you don't want heads to come together and have a cut stop a great fight like this one.
Watch your heads!
Both fighters showing the early signs of fatigue. It's been a rapid pace to this tough, grueling fight. Remember, throughout, it's been Rosario that has plotted forward.
Let's go.
McKinney warns both of them about banging their heads. Camacho back looking the way he was in the early going. Now he hangs on with that left hand and wails to the right.
Stop holding and heading.
Again, he warns Camacho. That's about the eighth time he's warned him, yet he hasn't taken a point away from Camacho. 1 point this fight could prove to be critical, too, the way it's going so far. ...45 seconds to go in the round. Left hand gets through. Camacho trying to protect the cut by the left eye. His head is bounced back. Rosario nails him in tight. The blood begins to trickle from the nose of Camacho. I believe he may have broken his nose back in the fourth or fifth round.
Up the holding. Hard. Break. Break. Let's have a break.
Blood coming from the nose, and he keeps grabbing his nose. You have to wonder if it is, in fact, broken. It looks like it, the way it's been flattened out. And if so, that happened back in the fourth or fifth round. It's been very, very difficult to score. I gave one to Camacho and one to Rosario. If that be the case, I have Rosario still out in front of the fight by about 2 or 3 points. Here's the pace being picked up by Camacho. Rosario not hurt at all in the exchange. That time he was nailed pretty good. And now the champ backs off the former champion. Again, McKinney warns him about hanging on and hitting. Camacho looking better. He's certainly got all his wind back. And just as I say that, he's nailed with a straight right hand by Rosario. Rosario elects to go to the body. Again, it's Rosario in the black trunks. Hector Camacho in the red, white, and blue. This is the ninth round, scheduled for 12. A very, very close fight. Camacho was in trouble in the fifth round when he almost went down. He was cut in the fourth.
Watch your heads! Watch your heads!
6, 7, and 8 have been very, very even. Very hard to score. Good shots being landed by Rosario when he gets in.
Let's go.
Right hand just really nailing Rosario, but it didn't take any big effect on him. He's in excellent shape for this fight, to be sure. Training down in the humidity in Puerto Rico.
Holding, right.
The heads are together. McCanty's right on the spot. Excellent job of refereeing by Arthur McCanty. Nice shot by Hector Camacho. Camacho beginning to turn the fight back around in his favor here now. Doesn't want to get careless with Rosario. He did back in the fifth and almost paid the price dearly. Nail again with a very quick right hand of Hector Camacho.
Watch the heads, both of you.
can hear Mercanti, the referee, continually warning them about watching their heads. Nice flurry for Hector Camacho. Inside of 10 seconds to go in the round. The best is Rosario was in the process. There's three rounds to go. I have on my scorecard. This is unofficial again. Camacho trailing by two. So he needs to win the last three rounds. If in fact my scoring is proper.
Stay there.
If it's not proper, it's something close to that. It could be 1 point either way because of the very, very close even rounds.
Time in.
All right. And they're ready to go. They had to get some tape off the glove of Rosario. Rosario needs to get another round here in a hurry, but it's Camacho on the attack. This is the 10th round.
Let's go.
And again, Mercanti warns Camacho about the low blow. Camacho never says anything. He just goes about his business. Rosario nails him with the right hand. Rosario needs another big round here. And Camacho needs all three of these last rounds to win the fight. Well, the first minute of this round, very even, but a slight edge for Camacho. The crowd now beginning to chant Macho, Macho. Or are they saying Chepo, Chepo? Or is it both? Right hand by the Chepo. Camacho doesn't want to stay on those ropes. He quickly spins his way out of it. Gets back in the center of the ring where he does his best fighting. The second minute of this 10th round, very even. But Camacho finishing with a flurry. Very slight edge so far in this round for Hector Camacho.
Watch the heads again. Watch it, boys. You're getting too close to the heads now, right? Take it easy.
Camacho is as tough as they come. He was in a lot of trouble back around the fourth and fifth round. He certainly recovered from it, but Rosario keeps the pressure coming. Inside of 10 seconds to go in this, the 10th round. Don't forget this fight is a 12 round WBC championship fight in lightweight division. And there's the end. The round is trying to get that extra couple of seconds rest. We're in the 11th round now. Nice shot that time, a left hook by Camacho. Actually, it's not really a left hook because he's a left-handed fighter. It's really like a left cross, bro. The boos come as Camacho roughs it up a bit with Rosario. Rosario hasn't been intimidated at all whatsoever throughout the fight by the roughhouse tactics of Camacho. In fact, in some ways, I think the way Mercanti has been on him, the referee, that it's bothered Camacho more, has been warned so many times. But Arthur Mercanti thus far has not taken any points away from Hector Macho Camacho. That could prove to be, if the fight continues the same sort of pace it's going and the same sort of style it's going, it could prove to be a very, very important factor in the fight. This fight is within a point one way or the other. On my card again, I've got Rosario slightly in front, but Camacho has been in the upswing the last two or three rounds.
Let's go.
halfway through the 11th round in this 12-round lightweight championship fight. Both fighters showing a bit of fatigue. But Kenny snapped Rosario back from that break so hard, he almost knocked him down. Don't forget, these guys only weigh 135 pounds. But there's a lot of power, punching power in those fists of these little guys. Little abrasion cut below the right eye of Edwin Rosario. His corner's worked on that. It was a cut in the corner of the left eye going way back to the fourth round of Camacho. Nice left hook scored by Rosario. The right hand almost drops Camacho. Camacho in real danger of losing his title. And this round continues this way. While Camacho is trying to bounce, he still appears to be a little bit wobbly on his legs. His eyes are clear. He backs Rosario off. Rosario totally under control. His legs look stronger than Camacho's right now. He's backing Camacho up. He nails him. Two good shots to the head, one to the body. Another right hand gets through. Camacho really on the bicycle now, trying to get away. As the right hand gets through, the left hook. And a strong 11th. We may have a major upset in the making here. Although Rosario has only lost once in his career. Sneaky right-hand lead by Rosario. And now they're toe-to-toe going at it. Rosario appears to be stronger than Camacho right now, which is very, very surprising. A minute gone in this 12th and final round. Rosario scoring again to the head of Camacho. Camacho trying to fight back gamely. He needs to score a big round here, and thus far it's been Rosario's round. And Rosario continues to pound. Camacho almost pushes Rosario over just about a minute to go in the fight. It's still Rosario's 12th round. Camacho tries to do something with an uppercut, but it doesn't land. Taken on the gloves by Chepo. Camacho must know he needs a big finish, but Rosario's not going to let him have it. Camacho is ignited, but Rosario continues to pound him inside of 30 seconds, as you see. There'll be no knockout. It's all over. We may have. He knows he's been in a war tonight. Rosario with that little slip below his right eye. Both eyes are puffy. They'll take their time adding it up. Here we go. To Frank Shane, the ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is the voting of the officials. Judge Luis Rivera votes 114 for Rosario, 113 for Camacho. Judge Tony Castellano votes 113 for Rosario, 115 for Camacho.
So it's going to be a split decision.
Dr. Stuart Kirschenbaum votes 113 for Rosario, 115 for Camacho. The winner by majority decision, Hector Camacho.
So Camacho does retain his championship. A lot of the crowd doesn't like it. Camacho retains his title. Two judges had it 115-113. Another judge had it 114-113. I would be inclined to go along with that judge. But nonetheless, two out of the three saw Camacho retaining his title. A most difficult fight. He almost went down in the fifth round. It was certainly a big 12.